So, the current madness is the Red Sonja sword from the 1985 fantasy film Red Sonja. It is yet again another normalish sized sword, but the reason I've decided to take this one on is there's quite a few things about it that make it technically interesting. That's usually my MO, is I refuse to do like normal historical sword, but like if there's, even if it is a normal sized sword, as long as there's something technically interesting, you know? For instance, in Dragon Ball Z, there's a character called Trunk, and he has a sword, and while it's from an anime, it's like a very normal looking sword, so it's very hard to justify why I would build that. Whereas, stuff like this, hang on, I'll line these up better later. But like, the reason this one, there's a couple of things that make this one interesting. The thing that I found most striking about it was this long Cree shape that's embedded into it. Like there's a fuller, and then there's this snaky shape raised on the fuller. So that's going to be quite tricky to make. And this guard has a lot of finicky stuff going on. I don't know if you can see it. So that will be an interesting challenge to make. So for those two reasons, I agreed to make it. And let's see how it goes.
Because the last sword took so long to finish, this one, this blank has been in the soup for ages.
Ugh. Ooh, this end is rough. Did this end get rusty again? Something weird happened to this end.
The entire surface gets ground, so I'm not so worried about it. This surface is mostly to make it nice and easy to mark. The black Sharpie against the white would be slightly easier to read than if I'd left it as the brown Hardock surface. Because of the ebbing and flowing of the level of the vinegar with the heat and then the refilling, when I ever noticed it was getting low, it's got a weird texture on the surface now, which is kind of cool.
So I laboriously chopped out all these little triangles, and the idea is I can mark the position of this Cree type shape on the sword without, because I need to, because the plan is to carve it into the blade instead of sticking a separate piece on top. And I can't stick a separate piece on top because it's too long and it's got this very narrow bit at the end. I need a good position of it, because I can't adjust it after the fact. So that's what all these triangles are for.
Oh boy, that was stressful. But that's the start of what we're going to do.
Thank you. Oh, this is a number 10. There's no greater pain in life than meeting the right person, but at the wrong time. Nope. Nope. Yes. What was it? 7/16 probably. 7/16.
Because of this thing at the back, it's not going on straight, but I'm not sure how important that is, because I can just weld the next part on straight. But I think that part worked at least.
This is nothing special, it's just a big ring, an offcut of something I found. I can't even remember what it was for. Although, could it have been something to do with the Blinding Light of Destiny? But I don't think I interacted with any of the raw round stock. It all came to me finished. Unless the handle was this... No, the handle wasn't this thick. I don't know what I was using this monster stuff for. If you can remember, post it in the comments. Originally, when I envisioned making this, I envisioned this guy being straight up and down in here, but the teeth on a standard die grinder bit for doing this kind of stuff, the teeth aren't designed to cut properly straight up and down. They're designed for, they have more teeth on the sides. And teeth on the back as well, which is kind of actually a bit, little bit mysterious now that you think, or that I think about it closely. But, so this thing, this already strange contraption I'm making, increases its journey into strangeness by being mounted at this crazy angle sideways like this. So, I'm not sure will this thing work at all, but we'll see. Wouldn't it be funny if I went to unclamp it and I couldn't because one of the clamps was like tangled in there? So that's the idea. The primitive depth control. Does the thing still spin or did I cook bearings? That would be awful. Can't push on it now, it's too hot. But that's the idea. That little notch there was the depth I was going for. The thing is all the way back in there. So I'll be able to reset it to that at least and then get deeper by bringing it forward. Although that process will probably be a little bit more random. So you have to maintain a death grip on it. But you can use it, see it skidded over the surface. You can use it to produce an area of near uniform depth. So the measurement on the my little test piece, this is what the thing was clamped into as I was welding it. 3.66. Let's do it again just to be sure. 3.72, so 3.6 or 3.7. We're talking millimeters here, you know, so... And a lot of that will be, most of that will be the ruler, so our margin of error is higher here. What is this end of the trench? 3.33? Okay, so it was biting heavily there, maybe it hadn't done it. The key thing is I'm trying to see is any of it deeper than that thing. 3.57. 3.65. Oh yeah, the middle of the trench would be probably the part closest to the actual original measurement.
3.74. Take a third sample from inside the trench. 3.71. Take a sample from over here. 3.84. So, yeah, so that piece is deeper. So, 3.8. And the shallowest measurement I found was 3.5. So, that's 0.3 of a millimeter difference. And I think this thing was originally tuned to be like 1.6. Yeah, 1.62. So, that's quite a big difference for, like, if this was like a milling machine. But for a hand tool, it'll hover 0.3 mil either side of 1.6 deep. Just by eye, though, you can, I don't know, can you see? The trench looks relatively even. Like, it's not perfect, but it's more even than it would be. And then if you add, given that, like, a manual polish on top of the dugout trench, I think that might work. I really need to work on it going wild at the edges, though. Figure out some better way of doing that. Die grinder, then this stone, and then the wire brush. I think that surface is acceptable. God, it's sprinkling now, so that's rainwater, you see. Just, I think that's smooth enough and uniform enough. You can kind of see there's like little things in it if I do this with my hand. But I think that'll work for the type of thing I'm going for. I'm like, you have to be very careful. It is possible to control the edge, but you have to be so careful to make sure the edge is facing you and you're holding the thing like this. If you try to do a forward edge, it just goes and makes a big mess. Took all day to carve that out. I think it's pretty good though. Something here I don't like that I might touch up. In shaping this one, this turn here got awfully skinny. I'm going to try and see, can I widen it out again? Okay, these bits are just a little bit less skinny now that I went squish, squish, squish. And hopefully welding them, tacking them both ends just means they didn't change shape too much. They look about the same shape they did before. Yeah. Everything's so hard to manipulate. Is it because it's the magnetism of the plate underneath? I don't know. But just everything seems a little bit harder than it should be. Oop, that's the idea. That's all of these little things. Well, actually, no, I have to still do the one in the middle. But that's all these guys done. Okay, that's now all of these little bits are done. Will this guy focus? Just trying to shape the little pieces to more closely match what was drawn on the various pictures I saw. The magnet does weird things with the arc, but that was good enough to get this guy tacked into place. I wonder why the magnet plays such hell with the arc. Whee! Holy moly, those little shapes were a lot of work. But, I mean, they look it. Like, it's not like they look like they... I mean, maybe some people would think that was simple. But most people would recognize that was... complicated and frustrating to do. Oh boy. There we go. I wasn't quite sure that was going to work because, you know, like I just thought on such a small piece that it might go a bit wonky. When the brazing stuff gets too hot, it burns out to kind of a coppery color and sometimes it's kind of patchy looking. Well, yeah, I think that'll work. I think now that's all left to do is to braze all the other ones, which will be just the same process, small fiddly process.
There we go. That's all of the symbols done to the best of my ability. Oh boy! They were a lot more work than I thought they were going to be, but they look fairly good.
Abrupt cut to me standing here. The mighty algorithm continues to instruct me that if I break my big projects up into 20-minute chunks, it ultimately results in more rations for my family. There should be a box floating around on the screen with a link to a playlist of all the parts of this build that have already been uploaded. If not all the parts of the build are on the playlist, they'll be uploaded once a week till they are all there. Alternatively, you can become one of my Patreons, and the whole length of the build video is up there right now. The whole thing, the chainmail bikini, the part where I'm wearing the duct tape pasties, all the different things that happened during this build video. If YouTube has gone and changed its thing again, and there's no box on the screen, there'll be a link to the playlist in the video description.